taking it on your own is like going by walk. Joining Toastmasters or going through a training is like going in a car. If you have a mentor, then it's like going in a jet. A mentor can truly accelerate your self-development journey. Mentors can help you maximize your learning and identify your potential, true potential. Mentoring is an art of transforming somebody from what they are to levels where they can realize their true value. There is a famous African proverb: if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. I would say in Toastmasters, if you want to go fast and far, go with a mentor. In the next 15 minutes, I'm going to share with you some important insights and information related to mentoring in Toastmasters. I want to thank Toastmaster Arul for making my job easy, because he already shared a lot of useful insights about mentoring. The first information that I want to share with you is mentor is not an alchemist, but a catalyst. What do I mean by that? A mentor is not someone who's going to convert a silver into a bronze or a bronze into a gold. A mentor is someone who takes a golden ore and convert that into a golden ornament. So mentor is somebody who's not going to do a magic on you, just transform you from somebody who you are not really to somebody who you want to be. But mentor is someone who is going to help you mold and give you shape, give you purpose, help you identify the maximum potential that is buried in you. So to relate to the theme that we have today, a mentor is somebody who's like an ice cream factory, who produces, who takes cocoa, who takes milk, cream, and ice, and convert that into a choco bar ice cream. So that's the job of a mentor. So mentor is someone who gives you knowledge, who advises you when you have a problem, and who serves as an inspiration. And many people come to me and ask me, my mentee is not even getting in touch with me. What should I do? Probably you are giving them knowledge, probably you are giving them advice, but you are not serving as an inspiration to them. So how can you really be an inspiration to a mentee? For that, you have to be a role model. It would be better if you walk the talk, especially if you want others to follow. So that's why we call mentoring role in Toastmasters as a leadership role. So a mentor serves as a role model, and that's how a mentor can command respect, not demand respect, command respect, and serve as an inspiration. So a mentor is a coach, advisor, and a role model all in one. There are different steps involved in mentoring in Toastmasters. The first step is understanding the expectation of your mentee. Call for a meeting, call for an initial discussion, and explain to them about the policies, procedures, protocols that we follow in Toastmasters. But most importantly, understand their expectations from the mentee, what they really want to achieve through the mentoring process. And number two, set goals. Jointly identify goals, and obviously you all know how to set goals. The goals have a well-defined purpose or an objective or a task to be completed with a timeline. So set goals. And number three, review progress periodically. It is very important to you have periodic handshakes, periodic connects, either through WhatsApp, email, phone calls, or even in-person conversations if the situation allows. So periodically review the progress. Four, appreciate. This is an important aspect, and this will also help you to inspire your mentee, because everybody craves for appreciation and everybody tries hard to become successful. So no matter what the effort is from the mentee, appreciate the mentee for what they have done. And last but not the least is raising the bar continuously so that the mentee can scale to greater heights. So to recap, understand the expectations, set goals, review progress periodically, appreciate progress, and raise the bar. These are the five things that you have to do when you sign up as a mentor in Toastmasters. So I want to reemphasize that mentor is not a magician, he's an enabler. If you are in corporate life and if you are used to this term called agile, the mentor is an agile leader, the so-called scrum master who serves as an enabler for the team. So that's the job of a mentor. Mentoring is always a two-way street. So imagine that you are walking into an ice cream potluck party. You know what is a potluck, right? Each one brings something for sharing with others. So imagine walking into an ice cream potluck with a choco chip ice cream. And when you walk in there, you realize that others have not brought anything to the party. You'll be very disappointed, right? If you are the only person carrying an ice cream cup and others have not brought anything to share with you. So similarly, mentoring is a two-way street. Both the mentor and the mentee have well-defined responsibilities. So let me give you an example. When I started mentoring somebody in the year 2009, that was the first time that I ever signed up to be a mentor in Toastmasters. And the first person who was assigned to me is Priyanandan. He's still my mentee, by the way. But we started our relationship way back in 2009. And Priyanandan was doing his third year or final year in college at that time. And his passion is about football. While I do not have any clue about football, so all the terms that they use in football are all alien to me. So normally, what he does is, we were all part of a club called Chennai Toastmasters Club that normally meets on a Sunday evening. So what Priyanandan would do is, he will send a long speech script to me, probably 1,500 to 2,000 words, mostly cut and paste from different Wikipedia sources, and it will all be about football. And he'll send it on Friday night or Saturday morning. And this is how his email would be. He would say, "Saro, can you please review the speech, add a strong introduction and a conclusion, and condense the speech so that it meets the timeline." Imagine, like, you have signed up as a mentor for the first time in your Toastmasters career, and a mentee sends a speech script to you a day before, or like couple of one day earlier, and you were asked to like condense a script, add an impactful introduction and an impactful conclusion. You yourself will be finding it hard to write introduction and conclusion for your own speech, but if you have to do it for your mentee, imagine the plight of the mentor, right? So that's what used to happen. And to top it all, Priyanandan would call me at odd times, either like during the middle of the day or very late in the night, and I would not be available at all for his phone call or any conversation. So we realized over the period of time that things are not working. So we had a discussion. We said, Priyanandan said, "Saro, you have to give me time." And I told Priyanandan, "Priyanandan, you have to be disciplined." So I asked Priyanandan to send his speech scripts to review at least 3 to 4 days in advance so that I can do a good job of reviewing and giving it back to him. And he can also incorporate the feedback, practice, and then deliver it at the club. And I told Priyanandan that I have set aside 5 to 7 p.m. in the evenings for phone calls with my mentees. And he can reach out to me on any weekday during that time, and I'll pick up his call. If I am not picking up his call, I would return back during that time slot. So things started working for us, and even today Priyanandan is my mentee. And Priyanandan, after graduating from school, college, he joined a company. He then later on did higher studies in US, and now he got a job in Canada. He's settled there, and still we are in touch. Still he reaches out to me for mentoring and support, not specifically for Toastmasters, but also for professional and personal life decisions, right? So that's why I say mentoring is a two-way street. Mentor as well as mentee has defined responsibilities. And if you are still not believing what I am saying, so this is one of the emails that he sent to me way back in 2009. Friday, December 25th, that was the time, and 5:26 p.m. is when he sent the email to me. And look at his mail content. "Please go through it and edit it. Suggest a strong opening and conclusion." And he's also saying, "I'm giving the speech this week, December 27th. So the time that I have to review and respond back is from Friday evening to December 27th morning. So that was the time window that Priyanandan gave me. There are many other mates like this, but I don't want to spoil Priyanandan's reputation. By the way, he went on all the way to a speech contest. He's like, yes, accomplished really, really well in life. But that's how our journey started, right? And so what are the responsibilities of the mentor? What should the mentor bring to the table? The mentor has to be sensitive to the needs of the mentee. The mentor has to be very patient. And most importantly, the mentor has to be available to the mentee. If the mentor is not available to the mentee, then the mentee will stop reaching out to the mentor. Then the mentor has to respect the mentee. And most importantly, the mentor also has to have knowledge in the area where they are trying to mentor. So knowledge and experience are different. For example, some people may confuse these two terms. It's not a must that a mentor should have been there, done that. But the mentor should have knowledge in that domain, or he or she should be able to point the mentee to somebody else who has the knowledge in that domain. So that's what is expected. So sensitivity, patience, availability, respect, and knowledge. So I call it a spark. So the mentor has to ignite the spark in the mentees. And the mentee has to be bringing readiness for learning. He or she should be receptive to different thoughts and different ideas and respectful to the mentor. So readiness, receptive, and respectful. Those are the three R's that the mentee brings. The third point that I want to share with you is a novice mentor gives you the chopper ball. A good mentor makes you go and get one. A great mentor teaches you how to make one. Especially in times like this where you are locked down and you cannot go out and buy stuff from an ice cream parlor. If you know how to make an ice cream on your own, then you are well equipped, right? So a great mentor always, obviously the original version of this was a novice mentor gives you the fish. A good mentor makes you go and fish. A great mentor teaches you how to fish. So I just changed it to suit the theme of today's meeting. Let me give you an example. I was assigned as a mentor for a corporate club. And that was again my first mentoring experience for a club, specifically corporate club. And I did not know what to do, honestly. So what I did there is every week I would go there and play the role of a general evaluator, because the general evaluator serves as the anchor. And occasionally, they'll also make me do a speech evaluator role. So I'll either take speech evaluators from outside or I'll do it myself. So over a period of time, these members, they said, oh, Saro, you are doing a phenomenal job as a general evaluator and an evaluator. Can you also please help us as a grammarian? Then they slowly dumped the R counter and timer role. So over a period of time, I was offering general evaluation as a service to them. So I'll just go there and do the entire general evaluation role, including speech evaluation, timer, R counter, grammarian for them. So over a period of time, they lost interest and slowly the membership dipped. From 20 members, I successfully managed to bring it to 2 members in 6 months time frame. The club was very close to collapsing. And that's when the club was assigned to another area director. His name is Karthik Srinivasan. And he signed up as a coach for the club. So what he did is he conducted a demo meeting in the corporate. He brought in a lot of people from the corporate to attend the demo meeting. And he also conducted educational workshops for the members of the club. So slowly one after the other walked into the club and he started conducting educational sessions. And not only that, he will make them play the roles. And all that he will do is he'll give feedback. For example, he'll be the evaluator of all the evaluators. He will never evaluate a speech or a role directly, but he will be the evaluator of the evaluators. And he will ensure that he's coaching and guiding the club officers. That's what the responsibility of a mentor or a coach is. So he did that really well. And over a period of time, the club membership started increasing. From just 2 members, the club grew to 18 members in 6 months time frame. So Karthik Srinivasan was a great mentor. He taught them how to do things on their own, while I, being a novice mentor, was giving them everything, making it easy for them. So, and it did not work out. So I want to emphasize that if novice mentor gives you the chopper bar, a good mentor makes you and go out and buy one. a great mentor teaches you how to do it so that you are independent, you are on your own, right? So with that, I want to introduce you to the Pathways Mentoring Program. Pathways provides a very structured mentoring program, and it has three different levels. First, just going over the material, doing some self-evaluation and assessing whether you are ready for mentoring or not. Number two, doing the mentoring, helping somebody to deliver one speech and giving a speech on that experience to the club. And the third step is advanced mentoring, where you are helping a mentee for a period of 6 months and then deliver a speech at the club talking about the new skills that you have developed. So in about 6 months time frame, you can receive a certificate for Pathways Mentoring. So they give a separate certificate for Pathways Mentor. And for that, you have to follow this process. And I would strongly encourage all members of this club, especially the ones who are getting started with mentoring, to follow this because it's a very structured process. So with that, I'll open up for Q&A. So any questions related to mentoring in Toastmasters?
Saro, this is Nanda Kumar.
Saro, sir. Yeah.
Okay, I think somebody is asking question.
You can please again.
Yeah.
Go
Thank
ahead.
You so much.
Yeah.
Saro, I think this is a very common question which has been asked everywhere, but like I would like to like put up here, like most of our club is facing this problem, like mentee is not reaching to mentor, and sometimes mentor is not also mostly available. Like he is not that much free. He may attend the mentee's call, but he may not call the mentees. There is some part of hesitation, or I don't know, like it is the exact way of doing it. Like what we can do for this particular problem, sir?
So it has to be solved jointly. And in addition, I think there is also a role for the VP education or the president of the club, because number one, you have to continuously coach both the mentors as well as the mentees. That's very important because both of them are maybe new and they do not know what is expected out of each other. So it's very important that you coach both the mentor as well as the mentees in the club. So that is one. And number two, the VP education also has to do a periodic pulse check with both mentors as well as the mentees. So they have to find out how the process is working, whether it is working or not. For example, availability related issues can be sorted out if the VP education periodically does a pulse check. I have mentored close to like 50 plus people, and there was never a time when people have complained that I'm not available. So for them, right? I've given individual attention, and even in this meeting, I see a lot of my mentees, right? Selvan sir, Rashmi, Mridula. So when they send me something, I ensure that I respond back, right? At the least. So that is very important for you. And you have to be consistent also. Even if you drop it a few times, then the mentee will lose trust and the next time they will not come back to you. So you have to be extremely consistent. And once in a blue moon day, right? For example, something really went bad. And if you are not able to get back immediately, then you should also tell them like, I got stuck in this, so I couldn't respond back immediately. But next time, probably send your speech script 3 to 4 days in advance. So whenever you're telling your mentees that send it by this timeline and I'll respond back, you have to ensure that you somehow figure out time, right? And Toastmasters has become a habit for me in the last 15 years. So it's like brushing and taking bath. So no matter how busy you are, you will still brush and take bath, right? You will not give excuse saying, oh, today I'm so busy, I cannot brush. So similarly, and thank God also has not put me in such emergency situations in the last 15 years. So I didn't have to give any kind of excuse. But again, people have to be coached for this. If they are not naturally doing this, then they have to be coached. So that's what I would recommend. VP education has a role to play. You have to conduct coaching. And there are times when there will be mentors available outside of the club who's more knowledgeable and more consistent. It's also okay to reach out to people outside of your club also, if you are a budding club.
Thank you so much, Saro. Yeah, that helps me. Yeah.
Saro, sir, as a mentor, don't you think sometimes the level of patience, which is again mentor has needs to get recalibrated, because sometimes like the cases where you then again shared in that again mentee reaches out in the last week, and suppose we have even hard rules like what you told, but the ice won't get so melted easily, and they again still reach us in the last week and then say that, can you please do it? I and then had a certain kind of work or mean something like that. So again, whether a mentor's patience should be re-again calibrated each time?
So I look at the role of a mentor as the role of a leader. And being positive is one of the traits of a leader. And your mentee can afford to, for example, send a speech script at the nth minute and ask for your suggestions or input. And which means they have violated the so-called service level agreement, SLA, right? So if they have violated the service level agreement, then you have all the rights to tell them that, sorry, I couldn't review. Or give some high-level perspective or insights, if you can do that. Okay. So whatever little that you can do for them in that short time span, it will be appreciated. And you also have the right to say, sorry, I could not do it because the SLA was not adhered, right? So as far as you are setting the SLA well in advance, then you can cover under the, hide under the SLA. But if you don't set any SLA at all, then it's perception-based, right? The mentee will assume something and the mentor will behave differently, then it results in issues. So for any new mentee, I set the expectations on day one so that they know what is expected from them. And I also ensure that I'm consistent from my side.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir, for that.
Saro, there is a question here.
Go ahead, sir. Go ahead. I'll go after you.
Okay. So
there's a chat. But I don't know how to frame this question itself. Sure. Because initially, all the Toastmasters, including me, we are interested in making the audience love our way of speaking or something. So I still remember that every time I sent a script, you wanted me to focus on the project objectives. Somehow you made me to focus on project objectives. Even now, I can see that a lot of Toastmasters, instead of focusing on objectives, they are more interested in making the speech lively or interesting. So how to make them focus on objectives? How did you make it? How did you change me?
Okay, so how do I make people to focus on the objectives, right? Obviously, if they send the speech script well in advance, I follow different for reviewing speech script. For example, the first 10 speeches, I'll go ahead and do some modifications on my own, and I tell them this is how differently you can deliver the speech. So there are times when I go ahead and even modify the speech so that it meets the project objective, so that they understand how a speech can be modified to meet the project objectives. Okay. So, but as they mature, that all I just tell them is ensure that the project objectives are met. Right now, I feel that something is missing, right? So, but it's important to let them know this is how you can meet project objectives, at the same time make it very interesting and make it very engaging. Okay? So, it's a dual-edged sword, and the both edges are equally important. But it comes with practice. You can't just tell them to do it. You have to show them how to do it first and then make them do it subsequently. And emphasize it every time they send a speech to you. That is also equally important. Right, I go with like a mental checklist sort, and I ensure that delivery skills are met and project objectives are met, comments from their previous speeches or improvements needed from the previous speeches are also incorporated in this speech. So I ensure that I raise them one step at a time, so that if they look back, they'll see a huge transformation. So looks like
yes, I now realize that.
Priyanandan has joined.
But I want
meeting. Thank you. Welcome. Yeah. Okay. I also see a question on the chat window. Do you have a mentor? So DTM Lalita Giridhar is my mentor, and she is the one who pushed me into taking up leadership roles. In the old curriculum, we had what is called as a competent leadership manual. So that's the first step that you take in the leadership journey. And she's the one who pushed me into taking up a competent leadership manual and start doing projects. By the way, before doing competent leadership, I had completed 30 speeches already. I was already an ACS, which is Advanced Communicator Silver. I was 10 speeches short of DTM. Okay? So that close, but I did not step on to the leadership journey at all at that time. And DTM Lalita Giridhar is the one who handheld me to get into the leadership journey. And probably one of the reasons why I'm still active is because I signed up for various leadership roles, because the communication journey ends really fast. Communication is like a tool. A tool enables you to do some job better, faster, with high quality. But communication itself is not the destiny. So many people confuse communication with the destiny, and that's how they are not able to continue in Toastmasters for a long time, because communication is just a tool to help you to achieve something in life. Probably there is a strong need for you in professional life. Probably there is a strong need for this tool in your personal or social life. But it's a tool. Only when you sign up for the leadership roles, this tool will get put into use. So in your other part of your question, why are you sticking around for so long, is because I have found a purpose beyond communication skills in Toastmasters. So I would strongly encourage you to sign up for any role that comes your way, right? Anytime you hear this term called, we need a volunteer for XYZ, just raise your hand and then ask what role it is. Then you will automatically get pulled into a variety of roles and you will grow beyond the boundaries. So in the interest of time, I'll take the last question, probably Rashmi. Yeah, go ahead.
I think somewhere both Abhi and Selvan sir added question part of my question, but just to continue. So in case the speaker like is not willing to even stick to the project objective, just to make it more interesting, they have written something, they write something, they send you the last minute every single time. And after two times, they stop sending you also. And when only when you hear them speaking, you realize that they are not sticking to the objective at all. And you really want to help them, but they don't want to be helped. What do you do? But you're still their mentor. So what do you do in such a situation?
So that's the beauty of Toastmasters platform, right? Toastmasters is the safest platform to fail. And even if a mentee makes the mistake of not following what you are saying and goes ahead and tries out something, I know eventually somewhere along the line, they'll hit a wall and then come back to you. So it's not like a mission critical nuclear reactor where you have to immediately go and turn the knob so that you prevent a catastrophe, right? So give them that space, let them go out, try it. They'll hit a wall somewhere along the line and they'll come back to you. But your job is to ensure that they are sticking to those rules and objectives, right? So you keep doing that.
Yeah, I think it's the fancy of making things interesting has become such a trend that sticking to project objective is taking a back seat.
Right.
And that is where I think we do face sometimes some challenges. Yes.
There is a very important lesson from Bhagavad Gita. I don't know how to phrase it exactly as it is, but the message is you have control over your actions. You don't have control over your the results of those actions, okay? And this is a very involved phrase, by the way. It's applicable in all aspects of your life. You have control over your actions, but you do not have control over the results of your action. So since I don't have control over results of action, I cannot say, oh no, I am not going to take action at all. There is only 50-50 chance, right? But if you look at great people who have accomplished great things, they went ahead and took that action, and probably over a period of time, they learned how to produce results consistently. So it's very important that you keep trying, though your mentee is not listening or though your mentor is not listening. But eventually, either you will change the mentor or the mentor will change you, or you will go to a different mentor and the mentor will go to a different mentee. Right? So some change will happen eventually. So it's important that you stick to it. So thank you so much for the opportunity. And for patiently listening. And if you have further questions, obviously you know how to reach me. And I want to reemphasize the key messages from today's session. Number one, mentor is not an alchemist, but a catalyst. Mentoring is a two-way street. A great mentor teaches you how to make a charcoal bar and create a mentoring path for yourself. There's a program called Pathways Mentor, and create a mentoring path for yourself. You will enjoy that experience. With that, I'll return control back.